Episode 4 picks up for Mila and Lucas when they're going on dates with other people.
Ridley and Mila are going on a date, and Lucas and Fenner are going on a date.
They've decided now to have an open relationship and see if that would spice things up a little bit more for them, or maybe kind of fill that gap that they feel they've been missing for the last couple months apart.
So she's getting ready for her date as Lucas is getting ready for his own with Fenna. Lucas is trying to present as maybe more Dutch than he always does. And Mila is trying to be like a certain amount of cool, a cool girl LA to, of course, attract Ridley. Mila has never been on a date with a woman before. And so she's not quite sure of the lingo or like how any of it works or any of the nuances. And she has this nervousness about her that maybe Ridley likes to exploit to some extent. The two decide to go roller skating, where we learn that Mila's actually pretty good at roller skating and Ridley is just not.
There were a lot of moments in the show where we knew we had to have the camera in motion in some way because characters were on bikes or they were rollerblading or they were jogging. And that was a challenge because we didn't have cranes and dollies and sort of big budget solutions like that. When Mila and Ridley are roller skating, the way that we figured out how to shoot those scenes was by putting our DP, Ingrid, in a wheelchair with a giant camera and having us take turns pushing her around and following Emily as she's roller skating around this playground. And it looked great, but god damn, it was tiring.
Making the little fun disco-y montage of Mila just going hard on the skates and then cutting abruptly to really just struggling and looking like an amateur out there. It was just funny. I had a lot of fun putting that together.
Ik ben blij dat je hier bent.
En ik ben blij dat jij ook hier bent. En hopelijk wil je ook nog een tijdje blijven.
Fenna is the close friend of Lucas's sister, so he's known her for a long time. She helped get him this job. But it's like someone being reintroduced to your life years after the last time you saw them. So maybe the last time Fenna saw Lucas, he was like a kid, and he was just that funny kind of, you know, cute brother of her friend. But now he's an adult. Now he's a handsome young man, I think. And she sees something different in him. He doesn't really know where he stands with Fenna. Their date seems to go pretty well when it starts out, but then she starts talking to her other friends, and he kind of feels left out, maybe a little bit forgotten, similar to his own relationship and his feelings to his relationship with Mila. But Fenna just ropes him back in and just makes him realize, like, just be normal, man. Like, let's have fun.
At the end of episode 4, Mila is standing in front of Ridley's mirror, and she notices there are all these cutouts of models and thin women, and that was our effort to kind of draw parallels between Ridley and Mila's experiences with their own body image and the competitiveness that can come from a friendship or a relationship between two women. We wanted to put her in a place of uncertainty and insecurity when she gets this text message from Lucas that says, hey, I'm not coming home, you're on your own.
That text message just absolutely destroys her in a way that makes her sad and angry and vengeful, which, with the strange emotions of having sex with someone who isn't your partner, can just bring up a lot of rage, as we see in episode 6. 5. Fuck.